Historically, hacking was a way to call for free at a payphone. Over the years, it has developed into something much more scary: identity theft, sometimes nationwide power outages. Today, learning about cybersecurity has become much more accessible. For example, Capture the Flag events focus on breaking websites or programs to understand how to prevent attacks. It's basically legal hacking minus the FBI knocking on your door. And that's what we're gonna do today. We have two challenges. One is JWT cracking, and the other one is race conditions. And here's the timestamp if you wanna skip to that one. Let's get into it. We have a single page called Secret Vault with some gibberish and an input field. The gibberish is actually a JWT. You can tell it's a JWT from the way that it is. Wow. And also by the two dots separating the three sections, the header, payload, and signature. The first two can be easily read, decoded with Base64 encoding. The header is boring. Payload, however, says the current user is a guest. Let's try copy and pasting it in the input field for funsies. In return, they mock us with a message, "No secret for you." Actual bastards. They subtly hint that the user is indeed a guest, though we probably have to change that. The clever of you have already figured out, just change the guest to an admin, done and dusted. And while that is partly correct, if we try doing this, the site immediately rejects it. Why? Because the signature, the third part of the JWT, doesn't match anymore. Think of it like this: the header and payload are scrambled together with a secret key, and the output is the signature. If we know this secret key, we know what the signature should equal to. That's what it means when the signature does not match, is when the server tries to verify it on its end by using your custom payload and the secret key stored on the server. If the resulting signature doesn't match the one that you send, that means something was tampered with. In short, the website calls bullshit. Using a brute force attack, we throw a massive list of potential secret keys. My computer here is trying 150,000 iterations a second, and somewhere after 4 million secret keys, we find the right one. If you want to see if your password is in a public list somewhere, without actually typing your password into a shady website, you can download a couple of text files from the description, open them up locally, hit Ctrl F, and make sure your password was not previously exploited. So, let's put our not-so-secret key into the signature parameter and we get a fresh JWT with the user set to admin. Put that in and challenge completed. Next up, we're looking at a page that manages money transfers. We start with 10,000 in the bank and a wallet balance of 1,000. At the top, it says special tokens are given to members with a wallet balance of 18,000. Sounds like a scam, but hey, we're just playing a challenge. Now, whenever a challenge has balance transfers and you have to get above a certain threshold, immediately you should be thinking race conditions. And I'll show you how to perform them without any programming. First, send a random amount as a test so that we can capture the request and use it for later. Open Burp Suite, we can see that amount right here, so we click send to repeater. Guess what the repeater does? That's right, it repeats. It repeats this specific request. Let's change the amount to something more substantial. Now we want to add this tab to a group, then right click and duplicate, I don't know, 100 times. This creates 100 copies of the same request, then select send all in parallel. What this is going to do is overwhelm the server with a bunch of requests to withdraw 1,000 from the bank to our wallet. Most of these are not going to go through, but while the server is processing one request, there is a very small window of time when other requests can get accepted. Let's reload the page and see that the wallet balance has gone up 3,000 while the bank balance has gone down only 1,000, essentially acquiring 2,000 out of thin air. So obviously, let's do this a couple of more times in order to get to the 18,000 mark. Don't try this on a legitimate website without authorization, because it can overwhelm the server and you will be flagged and reported. As we reload for the last time, it just gives us the flag and we can go to the next challenge. Hope you enjoyed the video. Be responsible. Have a good one.